I do like that cat poster.
Yeah, very... I'm trying to get serious with the cat posters here. So a lot, this is definitely one of players' least favorite maps, I would say,
wow.
On the ladder. Is that going to affect? That's not going to affect
anything. Nope. Excellent. All right, good to hear. Thanks. Ooh. All right, so let's take a look at what they're doing with the builds here. So like I was saying earlier, Narazuri is our hero highlight from last week. So he's someone to keep an eye on.
Definitely need to turn the game sound up, I think. But we'll take care of it later, I guess. Let us know if you guys want the game sound up. I'm still... What?
Said volume's still good. What? Volume is still good.
Oh. All right, let's see what we got here. So, Temple of Anubis, three main routes here. Middle is Death Sentence, Gauntlet will crush you. This left side kind of gives you a little bit more flexibility, gives you a couple alternate pathways, but players really prefer this right side, so we're going to see what this team does. They are just going straight down the middle. And they get a quick pick on the tank there.
Yeah, there's no messing around. They didn't bother with any room at all there. I always like going to the left room.
And this is a really quick take here by Team Jade. I think it is. Yes. So Team Jade quickly taking over the point.
Would that qualify as a dive comp, I think? Because you got your Genji, your Winston, D.Va...
Yeah, I mean, they're missing Lucio's probably the only thing not there, but it's pretty much the definition of a dive comp.
I always get nervous using the Ana Zen combo for healing, but you would disagree, right? Because Ana's pretty powerful.
No, you know, Ana's definitely good.
Wow, they're really good.
They're going to be pushing in here really aggressively. I'm trying to make this dive comp work. Dive comps work really well when the other team doesn't have ults to stop it or aren't in a position to. And right now it's looking pretty rough as Hawk just cleans up the other team.
Oh my.
Keep in mind that this Jade team was a team that did go down with only one win under their belt last time, but it's not over. Yes, it is over.
Oh my.
Really quick take here by Team Jade.
Ooh. That was unexpected.
I think that, you know... It's interesting that they went down the middle like that, even for a dive comp. So we can scan over
like,
the rope.
I was going to say, a dive comp, at least in my kind of experience in my potato tier play, is always usually going in either one of the sides.
Yeah.
You kind of bleed out those entryways and then jump right in. The straight down the middle approach, I feel I've always gotten steamrolled.
When you're positioned here, you have pretty good advantage to just rain down death on them. With that monkey diving in, you usually want to be able to take care of it. I didn't see what they said about... I didn't see if we had another Winston, but usually once the other team starts to come in here, you can just kind of unload the wrath on them. But I guess with that Winston, it allows for a little bit quicker dive to get up top, to disrupt this line. So... It obviously worked out for him.
Yeah, let's see if Sapphire responds with that going straight in.
Well, based off their build, it looks like they're trying to do the exact same thing. They've got their Genji, their Winston.
But they are going with a Mercy instead of a Lucio.
Yeah, well, instead of an Ana. Jane went in there with an Ana.
I meant to say, like, if you're going to go with a traditional dive comp as we know it today.
Yes.
We're not seeing Lucio.
So they're
there.
Missing out on an opportunity for some good speed. So we'll see if that ends up hurting them. Plus... You know, the Ana, the debuff nade, if you get one of those off, you're in good shape. So we'll see what they're able to do. We got a pretty traditional defensive team here out of Jade, holding on strong here.
Also important to note, I mean, both of our Genjis here, Ninja and Hawk on Team Jade there, are both standout players that we've seen, both in the past season and then this current last week as well.
And here we go, Narazuri. Our player of the week, actually. If you guys check out our Facebook page, we got a note right up there. Ooh, and a big boop there.
Booped right
That's
off.
That's really bad for
Let's see what he does.
Jade
Let's see what
there.
He does.
But Hawk able to pick up the kills there. It's needed to keep his team alive. But Freestraw's coming in really aggressive, and he's able to get out almost.
Good bubble placement, though, right there in the middle. Helps stop some of that.
Absolutely. We got a lot of back and forth here. We got Ninja trying to take over these squishies. If he can get to them, that's going to be real tough. There we go. Two. Pick them up. Sapphire. Looks like they might be able to take the point here. Ninja taking his team to victory. Really nice job.
Wow. Ninja, really good standout play there.
So this is dangerous here. If Naraziri gets picked up, no, he's going back. But if you get picked up early on this point and you have a disadvantage going into that last point, it can be really hard. So both teams really taking on this first point incredibly quickly. We're going to see if they're able to cap it right back.
Wow.
So we'll be looking at this from Team Jade's perspective. You can see Blitzbolt coming in with the pharmacy up here. Trying to take a couple pot shots. Yibo getting low, but SJ Ripper takes him down. So this is a good way to deal with Winston, is that nade, that Anna nade, is going to be really challenging to work with. This is going to pretty much force Team Sapphire to back off.
Yeah.
So like I was saying, one big weakness to a dive comp is once your enemy team starts to build up their alts, it becomes a lot less effective because you have these responses for these very aggressive pushes. So Team Sapphire may need to rethink their strategy. They've got tons of time. 6 minutes is a really long time. So we'll be able to see if they're able to do anything with it.
Yeah, it should be pretty easy for them to switch up here as well. They're all together right now. They're not seeing them trickle in.
And this is Will on this Ignite 9 account, and he's definitely been one of those Zarya's that just managed to make things happen. But Ninjas get this pick on their Tracer, and they're going in hot here.
Ooh, Zarya on Zarya action there. That's tough.
Ooh, big ult by Naraziri, though, but it's not going to be enough. Team Sapphire is completely taking over this point, and they've still got Link's res up. So even if a lot of people go down, you can easily pop them back up.
Ooh, he's holding off. He's holding off.
I don't know if that's a good call, but see if
we'll find out. Wow.
Both teams picking up, throwing it right back.
Wow. So we got both teams here over 5 minutes of time. What do we have? 5:19 there for Sapphire, and we got 6:37 with Jade. So we got a minute and a half disparity there.
You know, that is not a lot of time, to be honest, for this. I mean, we've got... That's enough time, honestly, to full cap both points. On the flip side, though, both these teams just made capping these points look really easy. Yeah. It is not that easy, typically.
No, especially point B here.
Yeah.
I mean, that is a hard point to cap. I am amazed at how quickly they cap that. Both teams. I'd expect it to be one team would, that would exploit their weakness, but I think both of these guys just proves that they have a really effective dive comp.
Absolutely, yeah. These dive comps, it's really cool. This season, we're starting to see much more of this evolution of play where players are not just sticking with that Rein, Soldier, Mercy, Lucio, Zen combo. We're starting to see this more aggressive Winston play coupled with some really talented Genjis that are able to make things, make opportunities occur for their team, get in the back line, shred up the supports, and kind of get to see a lot more action in these plays.
Ooh, look, we got a Roadhog there. Hawk is playing on Team Jade there. That'll be interesting. Try and get some picks there when they start coming through. Let's see what happens.
So you're running that pharmacy again. Both these teams are switching up a lot. They're looking for the boop again. That was huge.
Wow.
Really nice boop there.
I'm not sure.
All right, Sloth coming in here, trying to pick something up. Backing up off the point, they kind of lose that high ground advantage, which is tough, but we'll see if it kind of pays off for them. All right, D.Va diving in. So they're holding on the point here, which loses a big high ground advantage. If Sapphire wanted to, they could take that upper ground, where Free Straws is to really rain down death, and that's what he's doing. Free Straws in the back. We lose our sound, by the way, you guys. Please let us know. Link's keeping his team up. Great heals. Down to 20 health there. But he's going to keep his team up here. And they're already Sapphire's capped this point. Really nice job. And they're going to be pushing in there with some great alts, which is going to be pretty major.
Do you think that's dead?
I can fix that.
Because right, I have a power cord, but you can plug it all.
Yep.
All right. Cool. All right, we're just having a little speaker issue here, but no problem. Games continue.
Shouldn't impact our,
you
our listeners.
Can you hear the game, I guess, would be the only other thing. And we've got a quick pick from Blitzbald here. Sapphire's looking to make a move right here. Coming in, another kill from Blitzbald. Freeze draws, pop dissolved. Blitzbald taking out the enemy team. Unbelievable good play there. Hawk is up. Blitzbald takes him out, and here we go. Team Sapphire, another fast cap. Really fast cap there.
It's so ridiculously
fast. They
have
4 minutes left still.
Oops.
Jesus, getting really excited at the controls here.
It'll still play. You won't even see it. Because it goes, it sinks right to the game.
Sorry, I alt-tabbed because I was trying to pull up on the other screen, thinking that they were on the same thing.
All right.
All right, so. Ooh, we got some symmetric play. You know, this is exactly what I requested. Last week. It was just a little bit of symmetric play. Is that so much to ask?
No. That's like, I want to see Orisa.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We're going to draw. Yeah. Perfect. So we're going to see what we can do with this symmetric play. This is pretty strong at this point. There we go. But, you know, this is the thing, though. This is strong, but if they relied on what they did last game, they ran a dive comp. There we go. I was going to say, if you wall off that left side, it doesn't matter because Team Jade's not going to the left. They're going straight down the middle.
Yeah.
Most likely. And so this might be a mistake here that we're seeing out of Ninja because they might not, he might not even proc any of those things. But, you know, you never know. We'll see what they do. Maybe they switch it up. And they got that Roadhog.
Oh, nice
up the
kill.
He's actually might be baiting those targets into those sentry turrets.
Oh, I do like that.
So, right. So there goes Narazuri trying to make it happen.
Wow.
And the whole time he goes into the car wash. Building up alt, and we're already at 75% for Ninja right here.
Wow.
He's gonna have his TP up or energy, and that was a really smart move by Sapphire there.
Yeah, Sapphire definitely planned that one out.
So you want to be careful with Freeze Draws there. He's on the edge, and that's really easy to get booped off. Narazuri going down. All right, we got action here on this side. They have decided to kind of split up from their usual moves, and
we just saw Mercy ult.
The Winston in the back line.
Yeah.
But it's, wow. All right, and Ninja is going to have that teleporter up, which is going to be really helpful.
Went with the teleporter. Definitely important with this fast play like this.
Absolutely. You know, that was a big... That was overall a risky move. You know, usually people assume that Symmetra's a support. That's not always really the case, you know, and you're running a solo support, just the Mercy, can be really scary. Now that they got that TP up, though, they buy a little bit more time. Ignite, full energy, just lobbing those shots and nonstop. Narazuri's trapped back there, but he manages to jump out, get out.
Those constant lobs just break the team up.
Oh, yeah, and they're huge damage. Those are 100 energy lobs. Oh, gets picked up. Shouldn't be enough to kill him, and he manages to get out there safely with the help of Yibo's heals. But now, Team Sapphire is holding this very convincingly. Oh, big alt coming in here. Bowser just taking him apart. Narazuri is the last one up, but even he drops. So now that was a full team wipe from Team Sapphire. And you can hear a lot of like the cheering and the yelling from that team, which is pretty cool. And I think it's really starting to get in Team Jade's head. They're right there. They're in the same room. They can hear the other team's like joyous shouts as they're failing and having team wipes. And maybe they use that as energy to motivate them, to fire them up. Maybe it sets them on tilt and they start to make some mistakes. You know, we'll see.
Mm-hmm.
Deus Ex trying to pick up some kills, but gets picked up by that Roadhog. Link in battle mercy mode here. Not dealing his
Link
tank.
Link is not afraid to go offensive mercy, that's for sure.
Oh, absolutely not, but you know, getting greedy, and Narazuri picks him up.
Wow.
Sloth trying to take out Will, he does. It's not going to be enough. So, one of the issues is that think that TP is still up, but oh, there we go. Link coming in. Big res. Thought that was going to be their opportunity for Team Jade, but
that was a big res for Sapphire.
Team Jade's forced to run back here. Ripper just trying to make moves happen here, but you know that's. Oh, he's just looking for that TP now, but I don't think. Oh, there it is.
Oh, he found it, but oh.
You know, you look at it. How many?
2-on-1 there. Yeah.
He only got two things on it left. You know, two teleporters. So you gotta wonder: is it even worth it to sacrifice your body for it? I don't know.
Yeah.
Especially because we got a big ult there that's just taking them out, and they try and counter, but
wow, nothing became of that.
It's not gonna be enough. Team Jade looks like they're gonna be able to cap this. So even though, I mean, they only had those two scrolls up, so yeah, it wasn't enough to really make it worthwhile. And Team Jade, though, fired up.
Well, they do have plenty of time here to cap the point.
Oh, yeah.
And they proved that. All they need is 30 seconds.
That was the other thing. It took them a lot longer to take that first point, but if you remember, on the first round, they had a huge advantage.
Yeah.
Alt coming out, but Sapphire's really pushing this back. Yeah,
we got
Team Sapphire's got this pretty convincingly.
Yeah.
So who do you think is, like, carrying... Oh,
boy, that is aggressive.
Ooh. Who do you think is, like, really firing these teams up right now?
Who in particular?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of hard to tell. I was going to say, I felt like in the beginning there, Ninja was really leading Sapphire offensively.
Mm-hmm.
And then from Jade, I was going to go with Hawk. I mean, they're both Genjis, but I think they played a key role in that dive comp.
Speaking of, Ninja trying to pick up Blitzball. He manages to get out of there.
Wow.
But not before Team Jade totally overruns him. And it looks like Team Jade might be able to pick this up.
Well, here's Hawk right here.
Diva's not having ult for this, but still might be enough just to keep him up. Two. Freestraw sacrifices his body to deal with Ripper's ult, and Yibo goes down. That's not good because they just lost their ult out of that. But might still be enough here. We'll see. Oof, we got a big soldier ult here. If he can make it happen, picks up Link. Great kill there. Gets Diva out of mech. Look at that bouncing around. Really smart plays there. Just unloading on these players. Trying to stay on the point, but Team Jade manages to deflect the whole push. Sloth, great soldier play there.
Caps
it for Team Jade. These are some extremely back and forth games.
Yeah, there is no clear champ on these. So we got a question here in the chat about the average SR on the teams. We actually don't have that average SR offhand here, but the way that these teams are comprised are you join as a single or a double. And what we do is we look at the SR as well as your roles, and then you're placed on a team accordingly. So the averages, I think it'd be safe to say they're pretty close if you look at the average of each team.
The averages are close, but most players, I would say, from what I gather, are around probably platinum.
Yes.
I'd say that's the dominant thing. But we've got people down in, you know, bronze, not really, more like gold. I guess I'd say some gold, majority platinum, couple diamonds, and a few masters, grandmasters. Each team usually has at least one GM, or at least one masters level player. So that's somebody who got top 500 right there with the moving decal. If you notice that.
Oh, yeah.
So, season two. So the animated spray tells you that guy was top 500.
That's pretty cool. All
right. So, here we go. We've got
All right, we got Sapphire defending here. Jade is coming in.
And they've only got a little over a minute to do something. And with the new rules, it's all based on percentages.
Yes.
So, every little point counts here.
Yeah. So, somebody can get in there and start touching it.
Ninja, though, with a really fast kill on Hawk, is immediately really going to shut down this Jade push.
I was going to say, they took down their top damage dealer immediately. So now they still have Sloth running around here.
Ripper's going to go down most likely. Oh, no. Sapphire, though, is... Oh, no. Sapphire has been dominating this. So Sapphire Jade needs to get out of there. This is a slow burn. Yeah. The longer it takes for them to die, the bigger advantage Jade's going to have for the next fight.
So this is, they can do one quick push, maybe not enough time.
Well, we're going to see what they can do. Hawk, I think, if he can get his alt up, you might be able to see something good. Nice deflect there on that.
You see the way he's kind of maneuvering his way around the back here without anybody noticing. Well, now the gig's up.
We've still got a little bit of time. Back and forth kills, but Freestraw is really doing a nice job. We got an alt out of Hawk here, but we also have the energy coming up for Ninja there. Trying and just going berserk on that point. Team Jade looks like they're going to be able to take this over. But then we got the res right out, so maybe not. If we can shut down this soldier, that'd be big.
Wow. They are really trading blows here. I mean, it's kind of hard to follow almost.
Absolutely, but that's it for Team Jade there. They had a good opportunity there, but the res came up, Yibo got them back up, and it kind of put an end to it, but really close game.
And for those that are watching there, I know we have some new players in the chat there, as I can see. So they didn't get any percentage because the point was still contested.
Not entirely. So if you look in the upper left portion there with the A, yeah, you can't really point into it. At the top of the screen there, you see where that little yellow triangle is? That's where they need to go in order to win.
Yes, to win. Yeah. Because it's segmented into three pieces. But I was talking about the percentage itself. There was no increase in the percentage.
Oh, all right.
Because they still need a cap.
So right now, Team Sapphire, in order to win this point, needs to get to the triangle, and then they're good.
There we go.
And if they don't, they lose. So the problem, though, they got 4 minutes to do it. And, yeah, I mean, Jade's really going to need to pull out all the stops here. You know, you're not even paying attention. Because
we got Orisa. Yeah. And we got Nirazari there playing, again, we can't plug enough. That was our hero highlight from last week, is playing one of my favorite characters. Oh, Rissa's grab ball, that alternate fire is one of my favorites.
So we're going to see what they're going to be able to do.
Well, look
here
at how far back they're defending.
They have to. If they lose any portion of the point, they're all out. But you notice this right here? This is it right here. This is why this is hard to hold this point on point, because they're just going to grab the high ground like they should. And look at that. This is just going to be a matter of time, unless they lose patience. Which they
and look at the
are
way Winston came in the back line, immediately going after the squishies. Oh.
But you've got a Bastion and an Orisa. And you know what, actually, on that ledge there, if Nirazari is as good as we've been seeing,
he can pull him to the edge.
Pull him right off.
Yep, that is right.
So this is actually not going to be as effective. Look at that. Drop, wheel goes down, and he dies.
Wow.
But Sloth getting a little wild.
Well, Team Jade's putting up a pretty good fight here.
Oh, yeah. Some special tactics. This whole strategy is actually very well thought out, because they've got this little fort that they've built, and really the best way to contest it is exactly what Sapphire is doing, but they're not considering Orisa's strength to pull them down. And then as they stay up there, Ripper flies up, disrupts them like that, and then flies right back down into safety.
Stays alive.
Maintain the little fort that they've created.
It's doing exactly what D.Va should be doing. That push, safe, push again.
We got our alt out of Bastion here.
Oh,
but
boy.
But he's getting totally tossed around.
Oh.
But Hawk. Ooh.
Wow.
Will doing some really good job. But a res comes out of Yibo. Keeps him up.
Oh, shuts down Blitzball with the Pharah alt pretty quickly. But now they did another
big
res.
Big alt, though. Big comes alt down.
Was that Sloth with that alt there? That was...
Yeah.
Or no, was that Nirazari?
No, that was
Sloth. That was
Sloth.
Yeah, Sloth. Yeah, I forget. Sloth is our Rhine this round.
So now we're looking at minute 50. They're at the almost exact same point that Team Sapphire was at.
That's pretty incredible.
Or rather, that they were at on the attack. So now teams are pretty much even. All right, they're trying to repeat this. We're going to see if it can work. Sapphire's not coming up with a way to deal with this. Team Jade really putting up a really good defense there. And you can see they're trying to do a more methodical push here, which is going to be, I think, work. This Pharah's should be able to do work. There we go. She's trying to get a flank here. This is what's going to be strong on this.
Oh, right here from behind like
Evo
that.
Goes
Took
down.
Out the healer.
There we go. They figured this one out.
That pharmacy doing work.
Losing the res is not going to be good. Hawk also goes down. Big all from Blitz Bolt up there.
It clears off the point, gives him an opportunity to now fight on the point. Contest on the point. Very important.
Everything's kind of falling apart here, and Team Jade goes down. That was a really good hold, though, for a long time. It was really smart play.
So that should be it for Sapphire now.
Yeah.
Wow.
Really, really smart stuff there.
Wow.
So Sapphire takes that first game off. Really, really cool stuff.
So let's see who gets this play of the game. Is that, I mean, there were a lot of plays there.
Ooh, Yibo! See this res. I think there's going to be that res at the end there.
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, look at this. Down to the no timer, four-man res.
Wow.
And they capped the point off that.
Wow,
so
that
cool.
Is impressive.
Look at that.
We got smalls and bigs.
Oh, nice.
So, a lot of options.
All right, we'll go over.
All right, cool stuff.
All right, if you want to chat.